Hi, we're back. This is Mary Foley.
And this is Susie Galvez.
And we're here live.
Live. That's a key word.
I know. Live from New York. No, live from Richmond, Virginia.
Even better.
I think so. The Southern Women's Show. Also called the Southern.
And it couldn't
show.
Be any more perfect for Girlfriend, We Gotta Talk.
I know, it's exactly.
Because we have done nothing but talk for 3 days.
And you know what's really cool is that it's been a combination. We've had gals come up to us and say, oh, I've heard of you guys.
That's right.
Or, oh, you guys have been great on the radio. And then there are other gals who go, we'll say, have you heard of Girlfriend, We Gotta Talk? They say no. I said, well, you have now. Because they said, I love the name of the show. And it's been wonderful to turn on so many women here in Richmond area.
Absolutely. It's been fun because we've seen old friends. We've made new friends.
Yeah.
We didn't know we had. No, absolutely. You know, we could have done a gun show or an auto show, but somehow we thought.
We didn't get asked to do that. I don't know. You know?
I don't know.
I think they just would feel a little bit threatened.
I think so.
I don't know.
Maybe it's our jackets. Maybe they think we're too cute.
That's right. So we have three unofficial awards that we're giving away today as we've scoured the show to find out the cutest, the yummiest, and the funniest.
Oh,
and so we've done the cutest, we're all the cutest jackets. And
we've
Belinda,
done the yummiest.
And we've done the yummiest. It's the Noche Wine by Cooper Vineyards. Now we're into the funniest. And we saved, I won't say the best for last, but we love laughing.
Well, and when you see these pictures posted on our website the next few days, you're going to howl.
So here's the thing. There was a skirt magazine who's here in town. Well, for our video, we're going to show what we did. They have a booth called the freeze frame machine, I like to call it, at the booth for skirt. And it's one of those booths where you get inside, you pull the curtain, and then, you know, there's four pictures taken.
But if you're over the age of about 35, you remember these things. They were so fun when you were growing up.
Yeah.
You know, it brought back such great memories.
They pop out. This one pops out of black and white
and you can see who's trying to be in the head. My head looks bigger than yours because I was trying to be in the center.
Yeah, exactly. And we were debating. There's this small seat that you sit in that's like maybe, 8 inches?
Uh-huh.
And we're like, how are we going to get two butt cheeks?
Two butts.
Well,
I think
we're fighting for that.
Quarter butt cheeks. We won. So anyway.
So this was all what made it fun.
Right.
And funny, because then we got really goofy, as we can all see here. So we wanted to ask, our grand prize winner for the funniest award goes to the Freeze Frame gals, and we have Lee with us from the Freeze Frame
machine.
I should say, you know.
And back after a flash, she's got a trip to tell us. But
I know.
Welcome. How are you?
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
We're so glad you're here. Well, you know, this would be a blast for any event, but I know that the big shows, and not only what you do, what else do you do with the Freeze Frame?
We do a lot of wedding receptions, bat mitzvahs, surprise birthday parties, several corporate events.
Wow, that's a good idea.
Philip Morris, Anthem, MCV has had us. So we're a lot of fun at any event.
So your booth will travel.
Absolutely.
Wonderful.
Yes.
Well, we've got to think. This brings a whole new twist to all those events. Because one of the things is you create these parties, whether it's corporations, but individuals, you know, and then sometimes people need something to loosen up. You know what I'm saying? And alcohol isn't always the answer,
right?
Is this not one that people just get in there, they go in the booth, and then they walk out howling?
Do they get silly?
They get crazy. We are more fun than most people can handle. It is amazing.
We almost couldn't.
It brings back childhood memories, which is always so fun.
It does. We hear a lot of stories about how people literally got engaged in a photo booth, mother and children in a photo booth 30 years ago.
Uh-huh.
My mother sent me a strip she took in 1937.
Isn't that
wow?
Great. That is so
goes
fabulous.
Way back.
Wow.
Wonderful.
Wow. Well, you got to tell us about this eBay story that you were telling us about before. You got to share it with everybody.
About a year ago, a bride is getting married. She cannot afford her wedding. So she got on eBay and put a bid out for someone to bid to be her bridesmaid.
To be her bridesmaid.
To be her bridesmaid.
In the party, okay.
To pay her to be her bridesmaid.
And she didn't know him from Adam's house cat. I mean, that's brave. That's a girlfriend.
Brave. Well, you know, there are professional bridesmaids.
I know, that's
my
true.
My sister was one for
that's
a while.
True. That's right, before you got married.
Okay.
That's another story. Back to the eBay story.
Well, she gets this huge bid from this mystery guy. And from a guy for $5,700.
Wow.
She said, but you're a guy. He said, yes, but the truth is I'm a representative from Dr. Pepper and Snapple Corporation.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to be there, but we're going to get a celebrity, a well-known celebrity to come and be your bridesmaid. Yes.
Can you imagine?
Gosh.
So we were at a bridal show in Chesapeake, uh-huh. and she saw us and said, please, please come to my wedding. So we found out what the big shindig was about, and we said, sure.
Yeah. Boy,
wow.
yeah.
This should be wild.
Yeah. yeah, get that. Yeah.
Absolutely. So now, that's going on this evening in Virginia Beach.
Wow. Okay, so I got to ask you. Okay, so here's this big shindig. Now, I know that when we went through, we got this strip, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
They printed out. Do you get, like, digital copies in the back end to look at all these funky pictures?
Yeah.
Because, you know, that would be...
The outtakes.
Yeah.
You just make them find something, like, you know.
We're always thinking.
Sometimes we threaten people with that, but actually... I think people feel less inhibited if they know it's just the curtain is closed. It's
mm-hmm.
very private. Mm-hmm. And only that they see their own strip.
Right.
So it makes people a little nervous to think that it might be out there.
Yeah.
On the big
YouTube. Even, the word strip might be causing a little bit.
It's a photo strip for crying out loud. Anyway.
I know, but there's a curtain. Who knows what happens behind that curtain?
A lot of different things have
see?
Happened behind that curtain, yes.
Really?
Oh, yes.
Now, how long have you been doing it, Lee?
2 years. Yes.
Only 2 years and all the stories she's got.
And, you know, she'll be able to write a book to contribute to next year about her freeze frame years.
Well, it reminded me when we were in that booth, Susie, and we were doing it, it reminded me of what the bit that I saw on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, where they actually, Universal Studios had a similar kind of booth.
Oh, that's right.
And then, because there's a woman's voice that comes out and says, okay, now get ready. Here
pose.
We go. Right, pose, exactly. And so now this voice
like this.
On the Jay Leno, yeah. The one on Jay Leno would be like, fix your tie. Yeah, sit up straight and say all these funny things, and it was really.
I think you were really seeing them.
Yeah, and then they would talk back, and then sometimes they would be like, "Go out the booth, you know, walk halfway across the street and come back." I mean,
they would do it,
and they would do it, and that's of course what made it onto the television.
That could be fun. That could be something fun.
Oh my god!
For the future versions, for those that pay
well,
for it.
We love it. We love it. Love it. Now, if someone wanted to have a freeze frame machine at their
event,
how
right.
would they do that? Where was what's your website?
We have a wonderful website, www.freezeframephotobooth.com.
Freezeframephotobooth.com.
And we'll put that up on our site,
yeah,
too, because
we'll
you're one of the funniest winners.
Thank you very much.
Thank
it was
so
great
much,
being
Lee.
Here.
That's
thank
right.
you.
Freeze frame.
Thank you very much, Lee. Well, now we decided there was just one other person that we had to mention.
That's right.
So this is an honorable mention. Of our funniest award here
yes.
at the Southern Women
yes.
Show. Now, I got to tell
you. I will
you,
hold them.
Okay. So here it is. I found these cocktail napkins that I thought were hilarious. Now, the first one says, a healthy diet, no alcohol. It's that kind of thinking that's ruining the country.
Now, I'm telling you. And you like this one so much you got two.
Well,
dear Santa.
Dear Santa, I can explain.
Oh, Lord. And that's all it
well,
says.
I was thinking ahead.
Right.
They were always
mm-hmm.
they were a good deal, too. I was thinking ahead for the holidays.
Perfect colors,
now,
too.
Now, here's this one. My last one that I bought was, I like to cook with wine.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes I even add it to the food.
You know, here we go
that's
back down that
right
wine trolley there. I'm
mm-hmm.
telling you this. But this is a perfect show for it because of all of our winners.
Now, they're not only funny napkins, but the whole booth, the Gaia booth, was
uh-huh.
just cute. Also had deals to die for. But what I really loved, what won me over, was the girlfriend story.
Oh,
that
that's right.
So first we want to say welcome to Loretta, who's with us in the show.
Hello, hi, Loretta. How are
hi,
you?
I'm fine. Thank you for having me
good.
Here.
Good. We're glad you're here.
Unfortunately, we only have a minute left, but tell us the quick story, if you would, Loretta.
Quick. We've known each other for about 25 years. My friends were closing a gift store they had in Maine.
Uh-huh.
I had seen all the merchandise that they had and thought, what a shame to let it sit there. So suggested we come down and do the women's show, and this is our first show, and it's just been phenomenal.
Wonderful.
And we've been having such fun, just an incredible amount of fun. And they're like my best girlfriends ever.
Aww.
But, you know, that's what girlfriends, helping other girlfriends out. You had that come down, how many states to come down and do this. So
yeah.
this is wonderful.
Yeah.
yeah.
And you told me that you're going to be doing some more shows because
yes.
of this.
Yes, yes.
Wonderful.
We were invited to other shows. We're
wow.
very happy.
Good
well,
for
listen,
you.
We have to wrap up for the day, but we want to say thank you so much, Loretta. Also,
thanks to all of our
thanks
guests.
To Tish, to Brian Hill, to Tim Hurley, Chris Reed, and Chris and Ben from Tagline Media recording this.
And Chris back at the office.
We'll be back next week on Girlfriend, We Gotta Talk.
Bye-bye.
Woo! Woo! We did it!